they just, they enjoy themselves. No sound. No sound. Okay, so you got to find a way to make up for all of these missing ingredients. So you go to a company, amen. Some of y'all going to accuse me today of just, amen. I'm not preaching the word today, am I? Okay, you go, this is what I told, that's what I tell everybody. You go to a company that has a reputation of growing their products, their ingredients that they put in their nutrients from fields where they don't use all the types of pesticides, insecticides, organically grown, where they supervise them and then they process them a certain way, a machine that's very, very expensive that do not go over a certain temperature that won't destroy the enzymes. So you come out with products that's full of nutrients which have living enzymes in them, raw. And you go with the oldest company that do it that way, that's been in business, but yet they are still what? Leading, they're reputable, and they have a good what? Good record. And usually you're going to come up with a company like 80 years old, 75, 80, 100 years old. Now, those are the kind of vitamins you want. Because you have tons and tons of labels, and you don't know what to get. So you need to get good nutrients through supplementation. You need to eat as well as you can. You need to what? I would strongly suggest, if you're really interested in living, you know, a career quality life, get a juicer. And buy organic vegetables and give yourself a glass of juice every day. But Sister Hill and I, we have a problem. The only problem we have is sometimes we're just too lazy to do it. Sister Hill said yesterday, she said, today, she said, tomorrow, we're going to get in this kitchen, and we're going to make us some juice, and we won't run out no more. Amen. But I'm just sharing with you. Now, this is kind of the lifestyle that Daniel led, and because Daniel led that kind of lifestyle, you can see how he was able to recall the dream, interpret the dream that Nebuchadnezzar had about the big tree. He told them what that meant. Then Belshazzar had this incident in which handwriting appeared on the wall. Nobody could what? Tell what it meant. Guess who they called for? They called for Daniel. Daniel came in, no problem. He just went through. He said, this is what it means. He didn't even, seemed like he didn't even have to what? Reflect at all. Here's what it means. He was just keen in the spirit. And the thing that I like about Daniel is really good is that God revealed to him, I think, the period of time that he was mourning. He was confessing his sins and the sins of Israel. He was fasting and he was praying. And God came in, and that angel came in and told him, said, thou art greatly beloved of the Lord. You've been praying, you've been seeking me, you've been asking what was going to be the fate of your people from this point even to the end time. And that angel came in and said, I'm going to reveal to you, Daniel, exactly what's going to take place, amen, with your people from this point until the end time. And that was when Daniel got the vision of the 70 weeks. Amen. If you don't understand the 70 weeks that Daniel, I mean, that is the whole key. If you can understand the 70 weeks, amen, that it was in detail, God told exactly what would take place, what would befall Israel. God showed Daniel at that particular time, I believe it was the Medes and the Persians were in control. He told Daniel, after the Medes and Persia, they're going to be taken over by what? Greece. Greece is going to rise. Then he told about how many, Alexander the Great, and after he get killed, it's going to be, the kingdom is going to be split up four ways. Told everything was going to happen under each one of these four different kings that would take over. Then it went from that point over into the Roman Empire. And then he came all the way down to the point where, amen, he revived Roman Empire, which was the last 7 years. Boy, he just laid it out. And then he even revealed, right on the end of his book, Revelation 12, about the time frame in which the dead is going to be raised. That's really interesting. He was speaking about the latter days after the time of trouble, the spirit of trouble. He said that the saints are going to be raised again. But he was referring to, because he didn't have any revelation of the church. And Job also confirms what Daniel saw, and Isaiah confirms what Daniel saw. What they saw was the time when Christ comes to set up his millennial reign, that all of those that have been dead in terms of under the old covenant, they're going to come back to life. Those that were slain and martyred during the tribulation period, they're going to be resurrected. Amen. And all of this, Daniel explained, tells exactly how he's going to be. Amen. In that book that God revealed to him. As he, all through the book, you see him what? Living a restrained life, open to God, humble, wasn't taking no credit for none of his revelations, visions, interpretations. He just really was a humble person. And God used him tremendously. So how many today are convinced that God, hey, by the first step, many times we can't get to the first base with the Lord, is because what? We haven't mastered what? The food problem. I'm done. Amen. Let's master that. And I think that if we can master that, then spiritual things will begin to what? Unfold. And they will be much easier what? Understood. Amen. So that's all I'm going to share today. Praise God. So I'm going to send y'all away happy. All right. Praise God. And my third point that our first point was self-restraint. The second point was prayer. He was persistent in prayer. And the third point that I was supposed to have done today was that he was a man that he stayed humble. He stayed humble. Nothing that God showed him went to his head. He never claimed responsibility for anything that God what? Revealed or showed to him. Amen. That's what we're going to share with you next time. Amen. But I just felt today that we wanted to just kind of focus on the importance of us living disciplined lives and to place ourselves in the range where God's power, God's anointing, and God's grace can really reach us. All right? So let's all stand. We're going to get ready to go. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. 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 Come on, let's just worship you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The entrance of your word. Hallelujah. Give it light and give it understanding to the Son. Oh God, we give you praise, we give you the glory. Hey Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord. You said that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Hey, the grace is not given to the swift, like of a battle to the strong, but to him that endureth until the end. Amen. He that endureth until the end, the same shall be saved. Father, we give you praise and we give you the glory now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for wisdom. Thank you, God, for counsel. Thank you, Lord, hey, for showing yourself strong. Lord, thank you for revelation and understanding. You said that wisdom and understanding shall be the stability of our times. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise and we give you the glory in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for beginning the good work within us. He who hath begun a good work shall continue to perform it. We give you praise and we give you the glory now. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. The name above every name. Father, we thank you because we believe that you are working your will and the do of your good pleasure in us. And we thank you for it. In Jesus' name, thank you for the victory. 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 For this is the victory of overcoming the world, even our faith. We give you praise and we give you the glory right now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your insight. Thank you for revelation. Thank you for understanding. Thank you for wisdom. Thank you, Lord, for leading and directing us. Father, we give you praise and we give you the glory now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. All right.